Hello, everyone, and thanks for watching. This week we are talking about fitness. That's right, it's Fitness Week, and we have with us Brian Loftus.
Hi, Rocky.
Hi.
In honor of Fitness Week, we are on the second story here. I did run up the stairs, and I'm going to try to avoid In-N-Out this week. So just in honor of fitness, I will try to avoid it.
Don't worry about it. We're going to start with what you and your family do to stay healthy. Here's our first video.
Okay, let's take a look. This is one of the things that I do with my two daughters. Well, first of all, they do, I should say. You can see, this is not something I could do in a million years. They're able to jump in the air. She didn't even use her hands there. Come on, that's just showing off. Basically, I'm just standing there with the pooch and holding a cell phone, documenting their incredible athleticism. But two really active girls love being a girl dad. Daughters rock. Everybody out there with daughters knows it, although sons rock too, of course. So I love doing active stuff with them because you don't want kids to be stuck in front of the screen or Netflix or video games. You try to get them moving as much as possible because, frankly, it's good for them.
Right, and I have video footage of that too, of you joining in.
Yes, this is our family bike ride. You know what this was, Rocky? Early in the pandemic, when things shut down, I became the de facto PE teacher. So every day I was like, okay, what activities can we do? I just want those of you watching on social media to know that, yes, my head is actually that large. Rocky did not blow that up on your screen.
Wait, let's look at that again.
I do have a 5 head. It's too large to be considered a 4 head. So what we would do for PE is go on bike rides, go on hikes, and do all kinds of activities because, remember, it was shut down. You couldn't go to school. They didn't have gym class. So you're trying to kind of go, hey, let's keep the flow of what they normally would be doing. And we all love riding bikes. And so this is what we do.
It looks great.
You know what the biggest challenge there was? Holding the cell phone and not falling over.
You were holding the phone?
Well, yeah, I'm doing the little video there while I'm riding along. I had no one, you know, there was no photographer there, so.
Okay, well, here we go. Check this one out.
All right. Oh, this is wiffle ball. You can't go wrong with some wiffle ball.
That was easy, right?
I'm the designated all-time pitcher. That's my 9-year-old who is, I find it interesting. She ripped a sweet shot to right field and never ran to first base. She just kind of walked it off like, Pops, what's up?
Amazing.
That was a Babe Ruth call. I'm going to just stroll towards you. Yeah, that was, that's a little end of a cul-de-sac, so you have no traffic, and so you can have an unfettered game of wiffle ball, which, by the way, maybe the most underrated game in the history of sports.
I'm going to have to agree with you.
Next, seriously, if you have a barbecue or a picnic, get some wiffle ball going. Everybody loves it.
Love it. Thanks. And here's a slideshow of
yes.
Another great footage. Awesome
girl dad. We love to paddleboard. This is at Lake Las Vegas, and when back in the Midwest, we do a lot of paddleboarding. This is hiking at Icebox Canyon. And this is Zion, another hiking weekend, as you can see there. I just try to keep up with them. And then, of course, you know, I grew up in Chicago, below zero weather. I love to get out and do a little cold weather Mount Charleston sledding when the season is right. So they are they're super active. They keep me going. I try to just keep up with them. They keep getting more and more athletic as they get really into their sports of dance and soccer. Both of which I am average to below average. We've all seen my rhythmless dancing on New Year's Eve. So,
that's the best. That's awesome.
I did give her $5 for that compliment, and you hit the mark perfectly.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Thanks for joining us today.
Rocky, I have a confession. Okay. It's Fitness Week, and I had an In-N-Out double-double today. Just want to come clean. I want to point out something we were talking about briefly before we went on air. You were saying how you see me getting my steps in the parking lot. I just kind of randomly walk around during my work shift.
He does.
You thought he's rather contemplative. He's just walking aimlessly. I actually think Rocky might have thought I was looking for my car. But no, it is just somehow to get, you never can do it quite consistently, but to get those steps in. Because we sit so much, right?
We do.
As are we right now. I'm about to go do the 5 o'clock newscast.
Right, right down there.
Okay, and we sit. So it's a way to get moving.
Well, thank you so much for joining us. And join us all week at 6 a.m. We're talking about fitness. Thanks, Brian.
Rocky, thank you. Thanks for having me.
We'll see you all. Share in the comments what you do to stay active. Bye. Bye-bye.